All right, students, good morning. We are discussing similarity of triangles and what is similarity of triangles. And I explained to you that similarity of triangles and congruence of triangles. I also explained to you what the difference is. Just to discuss some basic points before we proceed further. See, suppose this is your triangle ABC and this is your triangle DEF. Okay. This is triangle DEF. Now, if angle A and angle D are of equal measure, if angle B and angle E are of equal measure, if angle C and angle F are of equal measure, okay? Also, if AB, suppose AB is 2 centimeters, this is 4 centimeters. As I gave you an example, this is 3, this is 6, this is 4, and this is, say, 8. Now, for a given correspondence, for ABC correspondence to DEF, notice the order. A corresponds to D, B corresponds to E, C corresponds to F. There are different correspondences possible. Just to explain to you, see, different correspondences. First of all, ABC correspondence DEF. Okay, the second one is keep ABC as it is. Okay, no change in this triangle, but there is a slight change in the order of the vertices. I kept D as it is, but I've changed F and E. Now this becomes a different correspondence. Take a third one. Okay, I keep ABC as it is. I don't change that, but I change. I got 2 with D. Now I take E out here. EDF. Okay. EDF. Then I take a fourth one. I take ABC and I keep E as it is, but change D and F. So I get F and D here now. So 2 with D, 2 with E. Now 2 with F. I keep ABC as it is and I put F here, FDE. Okay. And obviously the last one, ABC correspondence, F. Keep it as it is, change E and D. Okay, so what do you get? You get 6 different sets of correspondences between the vertices of two triangles. If any one correspondence is a similarity, if any one correspondence out of this is a similarity, then the triangles are said to be similar. Is a similarity. Okay, if any one out of these 6 is a similarity, then the triangles are said to be similar. Triangles are said to be similar. Okay, so in other words, all the 6 may not be similar, all the 6 set of correspondences. If only one set of correspondence is similar, for example, in this case, ABCDEF. For this correspondence, out of this, if any one correspondence is a similarity, then the triangles are said to be similar. Okay, but for the given correspondence only. For this correspondence, the triangles are similar. Alright, so for triangle ABC correspondence DEF, if angle A is congruent to angle A and D, angle A is congruent to angle D, angle B is congruent to angle E, angle C is congruent to angle F, okay? And the second condition, this is the first condition, and AB upon DE is equal to BC upon EF, and that is equal to AC upon DF, okay? Then if both the conditions are satisfied, then we say that ABC correspondence DEF, this particular correspondence, only this one, okay, is a similarity. Okay, it is a similarity, and because it is a similarity, we say therefore triangle ABC is similar. This is a symbol for similarity, similar to triangle DEF. Okay, this is what we have discussed. You can see that AB upon DE is half, BC upon EF is also half, AC upon DF is also half. That means this ratio of the sides are in the same proportion or in equal proportion. That means AB upon DE is equal to BC upon EF is equal to AC upon DF, and in this particular case it is equal to half. Okay, because the ratio of the sides are in the same proportion, the corresponding angles are congruent. Congruent means equal measure, and therefore the triangles are said to be similar for the given correspondence. And as I explained, out of six possible correspondences between the vertices of two triangles, if any one of them is similar, then the triangles are said to be similar. So we have got two necessary conditions. Okay, number one, the angles must be congruent. If the angles are congruent and the sides are in the same proportion, but are both the conditions necessary? You see, you will find later on that if out of the three angles, if only two angles are congruent, the third angle is automatically congruent, because the sum of the three angles is always equal to 180. So if two angles are equal, say for example, if this is 60 degrees and this is also 60 degrees, they are equal. Now this is suppose 80 degrees, then this is 80 degrees. So two angles are equal. So the third angle will automatically be equal, because the sum of three angles is 180 degrees. So in reality, all we have to do is check two angles. If for a given correspondence, if two angles are congruent, the third angle is automatically going to be congruent. Now if the three angles are equal, in other words, if we have checked two angles and they are congruent, the shapes are going to be the same. If the shape is same, then the triangles are always going to be similar. Okay, shape is important, not the size. Size is important for congruent triangles. Congruent triangles are equal in shape and size, whereas similar triangles are the same in shape. For example, see these two hands. Okay, if you look at my hands, then you can see there both of them are superimposed one on the other, and they look absolutely identical. This is an example of similar as well as congruent figures. Say for example, let us just take, I've got a square here. Okay, this is a square ABCD. See, I am trying to explain all the basic things to you because it is important. And I have got another square here. Okay, this is P, Q, R, S. Both are square. This is also a square and this is also a square. In a square, all the angles are 90 degrees. All the angles are 90 degrees. So the angles are the same. Since the angles are same, all the angles are 90 degrees. Okay, 90 degrees, 90 degrees and 90 degrees. The angles are the same, and therefore you see the shapes is going to be the same. They are square, and all the four angles are equal. All the sides are may not be equal. For example, if this is say 2 centimeters, this is say 6 centimeters. Okay, in a square all the angle, all the sides are equal. So this is going to be, this is going to be 2, this is going to be 2. In the same way, this is going to be 6, this is going to be 6, this is going to be 6. Therefore, AB upon P, therefore AB upon PQ is going to be 2 3s are 6, 1 upon 3. Similarly, AB upon PQ is 1 upon 3, BC upon QR is also 1 upon 3, CD upon SR is also 1 upon 3, and AD upon PS is also 1 upon 3. So all the sides are in the same proportion. So what can you say? Therefore, two squares are always, always similar. You can see that. They may not be congruent. This one is smaller, this one is bigger, so they are not congruent, but they are definitely similar. In fact, similar figures are not always congruent, but congruent figures are always similar. Okay, let us take a circle. See, this is another circle. Okay, this is a circle with center P and radius 2 centimeters. This is a circle with center Q and radius 3 centimeters. Now, obviously, this is the bigger circle, this is the smaller circle. Radius is 2 centimeters, radius is 3 centimeters. So, circle with center P and radius 2. And circle with center Q and radius 3. Okay, are they congruent? No, they are not congruent, because this one is smaller, this one is bigger. But are they similar? Yes, they are similar figures, because you can see the shape is the same. Okay, same shape. Shape is same, sizes are different. So therefore, they will always be similar. So two circles, two squares are always similar. Two circles are always similar. But let us examine a circle, or rather a square and a rectangle. See, this is a square. Okay, In a square, all the angles are right angles. So therefore, this is 90, this is 90, this is 90 degrees and 90 degrees. Okay. Now let us examine this with respect to a triangle, rather a rectangle. Okay. This is suppose PQRS. This is a rectangle, and this is a square ABCD. All right. Now in this case, you will find that rectangle also all the angles are 90 degrees in a rectangle. 90 degrees, 90 degrees, okay? But in a square, all the four sides are equal. In a rectangle, all the four sides are not equal. So if this is, say, for example, 4 centimeters, this is 6 centimeters, this is 4, and this is 6. So if I take AB upon PQ, AB upon PQ will be equal to 2 upon 6, will be equal to 1 upon 3. But if I take BC upon QR, will be 2 upon 4 and that will be half. Now you can see the sides are in not the same proportion. Sides are not in the same proportion. Therefore, not similar. Therefore, the figures are not similar. So in other words, what do we understand? Okay, shape is also important and size is also important. Why? Because when you want congruent figures, the shape and size is also the same. But when you want similar figures, the shape should be the same. Here, this is a square. And this is a rectangle. The shapes are not the same. The shapes are different. Here the shapes are same. So two circles are always similar. Two squares are always similar. But a rectangle and a square are not similar. Okay. So once again, these are some basic things that I'm trying to explain to you. Make sure you understand it. Okay. A triangle has 6 different sets of correspondences between the vertices of a triangle. When we talk about similarity, we are talking about these 6 correspondences. So, out of these 6 correspondences, any one correspondence has to be similar. If any one correspondence, the given correspondence, ABC correspondence DEF, okay, this double-sided arrow, double-headed arrow is called correspondence. ABC correspondence DEF, for this given correspondence, the angles, angle A corresponding to angle D must be equal, angle B corresponding to angle E must be equal, angle C corresponds to angle F, they must be equal. And the sides, the ratio of the sides is the same. That means the ratio of sides is in the same proportion. Then we say that for this given similarity, the triangles are similar. And if one of them is similar, one of the given correspondence is similar, then the triangles are similar. Alright? So this is important now. Now, since we have got the basics out of the way, let us try and understand theorem 6.1. Okay, this is an important theorem. Theorem 6.1, please pay attention to this, because this one has been asked several times in the exam, and this is 6.1. Remember, it has been asked several times in the exam and it could be asked yet again. Okay, theorem 6.1 is also called fundamental theorem of equal proportions. Fundamental theorem of equal proportions. Alright, let us understand the fundamental theorem of equal proportion. What does it mean? Now, let us suppose I have a triangle here. Okay? Say this is your triangle ABC. Alright? Now, I have a line out here. This way. This is suppose line L. Okay? This is your line L. And this line L, L is parallel to line segment BC. That means the third side BC. Suppose L intersects here. Okay, in point D, and it intersects AC in point E. Okay, so these are the two points of intersection. We know that if a line is parallel to one side of a triangle, then it can intersect those two other sides. It can intersect if it does not pass through the vertex. If it passes through the vertex, obviously it is not going to be a separate line. It will be line AB. It can't pass through the vertex. So a line parallel to any one side of a triangle, intersecting one side of a triangle, that is AB. Here L is parallel to BC and L intersects line segment AB in point D. Then it will definitely intersect AC. Let us suppose it intersects AC in point E. So it means, therefore what does it mean? That line DE, this line DE is the same as line L. That means we can say that DE line segment is parallel to BC. Okay, they are parallel. So they are parallel, number one. Now, we want to prove that, what do we really want to prove? In triangle ABC, if a line L is parallel to one side of a triangle, intersecting the other two sides in two distinct points, then in two distinct points, then prove that number one, okay, AD upon, that is AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. AD upon BD is equal to AD upon AE upon CE. All right, this is what you want to prove. There are other two other things also, we'll come to that afterwards, but just focus on this one. Now, what is fundamental theorem of equal proportion, or theorem 6.1, which is very important? Once again, in triangle ABC, if a line L is parallel to BC, intersecting the other two sides in two distinct points, then it cuts off equal intercepts, or equal, the sides cut off are in equal proportion. They are in equal proportion. What does equal proportion mean? It means AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. This is what we want to prove. We want to prove this. Okay? All this is given. This is given to us. Now, if I want to prove this, first of all, let us just join this. Okay? And join CD also. This way. Then at the same time, let us take a perpendicular. Remember, area of a triangle requires base and altitude. This is, okay? Let us suppose this is N and this is M. Okay, now first of all, you can see there are four different triangles, triangle ABE, triangle BBC on this side, and two triangles on this side. And because these are altitudes, let us take area of triangle. See, area of triangle, which triangle I'm taking? ADE, ADE, area of triangle ADE. Okay, AR stands for area. Area of triangle ADE is equal to half into base. Base is AD into corresponding altitude. The altitude is EN. Alright, let this be result number one. And triangle, area of triangle BDE. Area of triangle BDE is half into base. Now BDE is, base is BD. And its altitude is the same one, that is EN. Altitude is EN. Okay, let this be result number two. Alright, now if I take the ratio of this, area of triangle ABE upon area of triangle BBE, I've just taken the ratio of these two. Half will cancel out, EN will cancel out, and what I will get here is AD upon BD. This is the result. This is the given result, this one. Okay. Now, at the same way, if I take on this side, okay, area of triangle ADE, area of triangle ADE can also be written as half into base. If I take AE as the base, AE, then the altitude will change. Altitude will become DM. DM is the altitude. Okay. Let this be result number three. And if I take CDE, area of triangle DCE, area of triangle DCE, half, remember this is DCE, half into EC, base EC, into altitude is going to be the same, DM. Alright, let this be result number 4. Now if I divide these two, if I take the ratio, therefore what do I get? Area of ADE upon area of triangle DCE, okay, half will cancel out, DM will cancel out, and I get AE upon EC. Okay, so I got these two results. Okay, now look at these two results. Area of ADE, here also I got area of ADE, that is going to be equal only. Okay, area of ADE, area of ADE. Now what about these two triangles? But area of triangle BDE, E, okay, B, D, E, that is this one, okay, is equal to area of triangle DCE. Why is this area equal? Because last time, remember, you learnt the theorem that triangles standing on the same base. If you look at these two triangles, you see, they are like this. These two triangles. This is your triangle B, D, E, okay, this triangle, that is your BDE. and this is your triangle CDE. CDE. Okay, they are standing on the same base. What is the base? This, and then they are on the same altitude. The same altitude. That means because they are parallel lines. They are lying between what? L parallel to BC. So two triangles standing on the same base and lying between the same pair of parallel lines are equal in area. So their areas are equal. So you can see area of ADE, area of AD, they are equal. Area of BDE and area of DCE are also equal. Why? Because they are triangles on the same base and between the same pair of parallel lines. And therefore, you can say that AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. AE upon EC. This was a required proof. What do you want to prove? AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC or CE is the same thing. So, this is the fundamental theorem of equal proportion. Okay, once again, let us just understand this very carefully. Okay, what is fundamental theorem? This is a very important theorem. Please try to understand it. Okay, just memorizing it is not enough. If you understand it and then memorize it, is far better. Once again, theorem 6.1, fundamental theorem of equal proportion. If a line parallel to one side of a triangle, if a line L parallel to one side of a triangle intersects the other two sides in two distinct points, then it cuts off equal intercepts, okay, on those two other sides, or it cuts off intercepts in equal proportions. So let us suppose triangle ABC is given. L is a line, intersects AB in point D, AC in point E. So now DE is also parallel to BC because DE is line L. Alright, now let us join DE and CD. And let us draw altitude EN and DM. They are altitudes. We require altitudes for calculating area of triangle, because the area of a triangle is half into base into altitude. So I have drawn two altitudes here. Altitude EN and altitude DM. Now, what are we supposed to prove? We are supposed to prove that AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. That is what we are supposed to prove. That it cuts off equal intercepts. Remember, AD is not equal to AE. May or may not be equal. But what is important is that AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. That is what is going to prove. Alright, once again, there are area of triangle ADE will be half into base. Base in this case is AD and altitude is EN. So first one, area of triangle ADE half into base into altitude. In the same way, area of triangle BDE half into base. Base will be BD, altitude will be the same one, EN. And therefore, from these two, if I take the ratio, I get area of triangle AEDE upon BDE. EN will cancel out, half will cancel out, AD upon BD. Similarly, on this side, now, on this side, if I take area of triangle ADE, half into base AE on altitude DM, okay? And area of triangle BDC, or at CDE, area of this triangle, DEC, is equal to half into base EC into altitude DM. If you take the ratio, then AE upon EC, that is what you will get, because half will cancel out, DM will cancel out. Now, if you compare these two, area of triangle ADE is equal. Area of BDE and DCE, these two triangles, their areas are equal because they are lying between the same pair of parallel lines and on the same base. Their areas are equal. So now, therefore, both are equal, and therefore AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. This is fundamental term of equal proportion. Now, I have got here, you see, AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. Alright, so let's just take this one step further now. Just a little expansion here. This was your triangle. Okay, A, B and C. Alright, and we had got D and E here. Now, according to fundamental theorem, AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. Alright, according to fundamental theorem. Now, if I add one on both the sides, mathematically it will remain the same. If I am adding one on both the sides, AE upon EC plus 1. I have just added one on both the sides now, nothing more than that. So, I get AD plus BD upon BD. I've just taken LCM now, AE plus EC, ones are EC upon EC. I've taken LCM, okay? But AD plus BD is equal to AB upon BD. AE plus EC, AE plus EC is equal to AC, AC upon EC. Or if I apply invertendo, that means invert both the sides, isko invertendo, that's what we call it. Okay, so I get BD upon AB is equal to EC upon AC. See this one, BD upon AB is equal to EC upon AC. This is result number 2. Okay, this is result number 1 by fundamental theorem of equal proportion. Now similarly, okay, similarly I get another result. Similarly what? I got BD upon AB, so I can get AD upon AB. AD upon AB is equal to AE upon AC. This is result number 3. Alright, so once again, according to fundamental theorem of equal proportion, you see here, if I got triangle ABC in which DE is parallel to BC, here remember DE must be parallel to BC, this is important condition. Then in this case we got 3 results. First of all, AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. Second result, AD upon AB is equal to AE upon AC. And third result, BD upon AB is equal to EC upon AC. Now all these 3 results are extremely important from the point of view of problems involving calculations. Okay, now the question arises that if the converse of theorem 6.1, okay, converse of theorem 6.1, and that is 6.2, theorem 6.2. What is theorem 6.2? Theorem 6.2 simply states that if in a triangle a line is so drawn in the plane of the triangle, see here, supposing this is the same thing, the figure would be the same, but explanation is slightly different. See here, there is a line DE. We don't know whether it is parallel. Okay, we don't know whether it is parallel. What are we given? We are given simply number 1, that AD, okay, upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. This is given to us. And what are we supposed to prove? To prove that, okay, what are we supposed to prove? We have to prove that DE is parallel to BC. This is what you want to prove. In this case, it is given. Here it was given that DE is parallel to BC. And therefore, you get these 3 results. Here you are given this result and you have to prove that DE is parallel to BC. That's why theorem 6.2 is called the converse of theorem 6.1, or it is called the converse of fundamental theorem, theorem 6.1. So this is theorem 6.2. Now here again, supposing there are 2 possibilities only. Either DE is parallel to BC or DE is not parallel to DC. Okay, not parallel to BC. There are only 2 possibilities. You can't have a third possibility. Either DE is parallel to BC, in which case there is nothing to prove because it is already proved. But let us suppose that DE is not parallel to BC. That is the second option. Suppose DE is not parallel to BC, then there is a point E dash or E apostrophe on AC such that DE dash is parallel to BC. Okay, that means there is a line which is going to be parallel to BC. If it is not DE, then there is a line DE dash. So let us just show it here. Okay, and this way, this line is passing through D and it intersects AC in point E dash. And now DE dash is parallel to BC. Of course, it is not possible, but we have to show that it is not possible. So now if it intersects DE, then according to fundamental theorem, AD upon BD, okay, should be equal to AE dash upon E dash C. Okay, according to fundamental theorem, that if a line is parallel to the BC, then it cuts off equal intercepts. But we are given what? But we are given AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. This is what is given. This is already given to us. Now, if you look at both the things, AD upon BD is also equal to this and it is also equal to C. Therefore, AE dash upon E dash C is equal to AE upon EC. Okay, now you can see this one again. AE, this is equal to this. Okay, this is not E dash E, but this is only possible. This is E dash C. Remember, AE dash upon E dash C is equal to AE upon EC. But this is only possible if E dash is equal to E. That means the point E dash and the point E must be the same points. We are what? We are given that AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. This is already given. And according to fundamental theorem, AD upon BD is also equal to AE dash upon EC dash. Both must be equal. AE dash upon E dash C should be equal to AE upon EC. But this is only possible if point E and point E dash both are the same points. That means they coincide. And therefore, if they coincide, you can say that DE is parallel to BC. Because they are the same points. If DE dash is parallel to BC and E dash are both the same points, then DE is parallel to BC. So once again, converse of theorem 6.1 is theorem 6.2. It is exactly opposite. Here it is given that the line is parallel. Here we are not given it is parallel. We have to show that it is parallel. Alright, so this is an important theorem, theorem 6.1 and 6.2. Please go through it very carefully. It's important that you do it patiently and thoroughly. Okay, and if possible, write it also somewhere. And finally, I want you to understand something. Please watch the whole video. Then only you get a proper idea. Otherwise, you will not get a proper idea. So it's vitally important that you watch the entire video. Alright, that's enough for today. Have a nice day and stay safe and stay healthy.